sir. Good morning, Fort McMurray, Wood Buffalo, and the rest of the world. You've tuned in to the Max City Morning Show. I'm your host, Elliot Pierre, and we're going to start the show off the same way we start every episode off, with a moment of gratitude. I know you could be doing a million other things with your time, so the fact that you're spending with us truly does mean the world to me, so thank you. On that note, Tanner, hit him with the intro.
How she caught me, loves. You're listening to the Max City Morning Show.
All right, and we're back. You know what, Tanner? What I've been noticing, because we did some on-site filming, is I hit him with the intro with my left on the show, but only because this microphone blocks me. I'm more of a right hit him with the left.
You are a right-handed person, though.
That's right, but on the show, it's...
I'm surprised you haven't just smacked that mic up the air yet.
I know. It's something else.
Not yet.
Not yet. All right. Well, everybody at home, I'm excited about our guest today. He's running for council. I have not spent any time with this individual talking about that, so you're about to learn all about him the same way I am. As you know, I do not introduce my guests because they can do a better job at that than myself. So on that note, sir, can you please tell everybody who you are and what you're about?
Yeah, thank you for having me on the show. No worries. I really appreciate being here. You have a great platform.
Thank you.
My name is Tal Tupper. I am running for Ward 1 Council. I'm originally, like many Fort McMurrayans, I'm originally from another province, right? Like, I'm from northern Saskatchewan.
Okay.
I'm from a predominantly Native community. I am Native myself, half.
Okay.
And I moved to Fort McMurray in 2017, but I've been in the oil sands since 2013.
Okay.
Yeah, at Albion Sands.
Okay.
First CNRL, Shell before that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And... yeah, it's been an interesting ride being here for sure. Yeah, I moved here in 2017 because of my fiance.
Okay.
Right? She started an apprenticeship for a heavy duty equipment technician here in town. She worked for a few of the companies, right? She was in a program to work for a different company every year, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now I've been helping her through that and with my job, which is I'm a mine surveyor.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. I went to the Haileybury School of Mines in Northern Ontario for that.
All right.
From there. And I've just been working through the field. I really love Fort McMurray. I've come to enjoy the wing culture here. Okay. Yeah. Right now I'm really into the wings at 72 at the golf course at Miskanaw.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I really like them. When you bite it, have you tried them?
I have not.
You haven't tried them? No. Oh. I really enjoy them. Actually, they're totally different. It's not what you're expecting.
Is this Miskanaw? Are you talking?
Miskanaw. Yeah.
Miskanaw. Okay. Yeah. I've tried the Miskanaw wings. They're delicious.
Oh yeah. 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 The restaurant that overlooks the.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The putting area there.
I like it.
Yeah. Really come to enjoy it. I love trying different restaurants out here in town.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's always like a new adventure, right?
That's especially right.
There's
more than there used to be, that's for sure.
Yeah.
McMurray's pretty diverse in 2021? 2021?
Yep. Yeah. That's the year.
That's the year. Yeah, it never used to be like that. As two locals, myself and Tanner, I can assure you, back in the day, you did not have the variety you do now.
Especially two locals who love food.
That's right. Yeah, the wings down at Miskanaw are really good. And I like the new restaurant that they have there. I miss the Fox Den. Oh, I really do mix the Fox Den, but I understand it went underwater and yada, yada, yada. But
yeah,
the new spot's nice.
Yeah, for sure.
So my question for you is, you're running for council, and I got it. Like everybody that comes on the show, I ask the same question. Why? I don't get it. In this day and age, in regards to the scrutiny that you incur.
Absolutely.
Like, I don't personally get it. And I think you're brave for doing it. Like, somebody's got to do it. Yeah. I really want to know people's mindset on, like, why would you bear this cross? Because it's a big one.
Well, I really enjoy the community, and I think I have a lot to offer. Mm-hmm. My unique perspective being one.
Yeah.
Being a younger individual, I am 35 years old.
Okay.
And I do believe I offer unique perspective in that I'm apt in technology, right?
Right.
I am apt in those sorts of things since that's what I studied, right? Modern technology.
Right.
And I believe that we can build like a greater sense of community in Fort McMurray, like especially access, right? Like, well, my whole platform is about access.
Okay.
Like, we still don't have a through road, right, through Fort McMurray, like, which limits a lot of the businesses that can come to Fort McMurray.
That's right.
Like, Costco doesn't want to come, right? Winners doesn't want to come because of the through road, right?
Mm-hmm.
But there has to be other ways to get them here if we promise that we'll eventually build that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And having more access to Fort McMurray will open up a lot more avenues for the residents, right? Like getting access to other places.
Yeah.
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 And
So that's one platform that you're running on. Now, in regards to oil and gas, so tell me a little bit about the, I think you're the first one that's come on the show that actually, you might not be the first, maybe the second, but has some oil and gas experience, which is new for council. They don't have a lot of oil and gas experience on council currently.
Keith McGrath.
Yeah, that's the only gentleman that I'm aware of. So
yeah,
that's definitely a unique perspective that you have.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. 100%. Yeah, I've been in the mining industry since 2006. I love what I do.
Yeah.
I love everything about what I do, and I have had a lot of opportunities.
Yeah.
In the mining industry, right? Because I'm right down there in the mine, and
that's
I'm
right.
working there with the big trucks, and I'm right next to them, right?
Like yeah.
I'm, they're using the latest and greatest that they have to offer, right?
That's so, right.
Yeah. So, unique perspective. Yeah. Like it, I've been very fortunate to not have lost my job in the downturn, right?
Yeah, congratulations.
But I'm very grateful for that.
Yeah.
And I've worked very hard to try. And
there you go. Now, you said you're from northern Saskatchewan. You're talking like PA?
No, La Ronge, Saskatchewan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like 2.5 hours north of there driving, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
You're really far up north.
Yeah,
you're
really
more
far north
than we are.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's where I first started in the mining industry.
Right.
In the uranium mines. I worked for at the world's largest uranium mine, the highest grade uranium mine.
Yeah.
And then from there, I went on to gold, underground and open pit gold.
Okay.
Yeah, gold mining, yeah. That was really interesting.
Now, with your mining background, I got to ask, because there's lots of mines everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere.
So, and like you said, like gold, like there's lots of stuff, diamonds, natural gas, there's lots of things to mine.
Salt.
There you go.
Absolutely.
Canada, killing it.
Yeah.
Oil and gas, you've come to Fort McMurray. You obviously, with the skill sets and the education you have, you could go different places.
Yeah.
Even, there's lots of mines in Australia even.
South Africa.
South Africa too, that's right. So what about Fort McMurray has kept you here over the years?
Oh, I just love, it comes down to opportunity, right? It's just the best place for me to blossom and grow, right? Like, I can bring forth an idea at work, and if it works out, they allow me to take that risk, right? They allow me to take that risk at work, and if it succeeds, it succeeds, right? If it doesn't, then you know, might not get as big as bonus at the end of the year, right?
That's
Who knows? Right? And it's really allowed me to blossom in my career, and just really changed the industry from the inside, right? Like like there's still a lot of room to grow
in
the industry from the inside, right?
Definitely.
And the best way, just like running for council, the best way to change something is from the inside.
Right.
Right. Yeah, and that's exactly what I aim to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, we talked about your road plan. What other things are you running on as far as your platform is concerned?
Well, exactly. Well, another piece of the access of the platform is creating a more centralized news source right now. Like a lot of people are telling me that it is really hard to find just the central news source for everything that's going on in Fort McMurray, like the events and just random news, right? So if we made like an application for the phones,
right?
It would we could centralize all that, like the events, like all the committees, all the boards. They could add to it, right? All the groups, and also local news, like yours. You could be featured on the app, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. 100%. Okay, so better communication tools.
Better communication tools. Right now, people have to go to like 6 different sources to figure out everything that's happening in Fort McMurray right now, right?
And that's right.
People just don't have the time for that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's true. There's so much to do.
Yeah, there's so much to do.
Yeah.
And that leads me to my next point is incentivizing what we already have, leveraging what we have in Fort McMurray, right? Like we need to get the youth more engaged in the political process. And the best way to do that is by incentivizing visiting and learning about Fort McMurray, right? If we got them to do that, which brings me to my next point, if we could bring blockchain into the ecosphere, right?
For sure.
Just for the fact that it's completely auditable, it's open, anybody can audit it, and it can also remain anonymous, right? You can still remain anonymous, and you don't have to worry about your privacy being invaded.
That's right.
And if we could somehow incentivize going out and utilizing what we already have, then we could also build more community.
That's right.
And with participating businesses, they could reap the benefits of the incentivization, right?
That's right.
Like, let's say we had a business come to us like, hey, we really need to drive up sales on our ice cream, right? So we get the kids to go to learn something about the ultimate frisbee downtown by the waterways, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you go learn waterways frisbee and go play.
Yeah.
And then they could receive, like, say, like a $5 coupon of some sort, right? They can go to this ice cream shop and they can buy the ice cream from there. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, the blockchain component is pretty cool.
Yeah.
I know my company, if you want to pay us, we will accept your cryptocurrency.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah, so it's a pretty unique industry to be in. Now, I see Tam has thrown his phone out and pointing at me. That means Elliot stopped talking. It's my time to shine. We have a segment called the Mac City Morning or the Mac City Minute, and that's Tanner's segment. So he's going to ask you a bunch of questions.
Yep.
I don't know what they're going to be. I wish you nothing but the best of luck.
Thanks.
Tanner, hit him with the Mac City Minute.
One of these days on a Tanner and Elliot show, I'm going to explain to them the story of how the Mac City Minute got started.
I think that'd be good.
Nobody's going to believe you when you say, oh, Tanner wants the shine now.
Yeah, yeah.
That's not how this played out at all.
It's funny because it's true.
Anyways, question number one. What is one thing that you weren't expecting to experience when you moved to Fort McMurray?
That I wasn't expecting to experience. Well, being from the north, there is a lot of services up here. Like, from where I'm from in LaRange, the internet there is 5 megabytes per second, right?
Right.
Here, it's like you can get 1.5 gigs. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wasn't expecting the amount of services that are up here, and I love being in the north, right?
Yeah.
And being in the north with services is even better.
Yeah.
I get to experience the outdoors, and I get to experience the best of what the cities have to offer, right?
So right.
Yeah. Question number two. What is your go-to style of wing?
My go-to style of wing? Oh, flavor and cut. You know what? I love the honey hot.
Bone on or boneless or
bone on, yeah. Oven roasted.
Okay, wing or drum?
Wing.
Okay.
Good answer. Question number three. If you could bring one retailer to Fort McMurray, what retailer would that be?
Oh, one retailer. That's a good question. Oh, I'm really struck between a lot of people have told me that they really want Winners.
Okay.
I'd really like to bring them Winners, but for me personally, Costco.
Okay, there we go.
Question number four. How do you feel like working in the mines will help you in your run for council?
A lot of the voters are all working in the mines, right? That's who we service. We service the oil sands, and the people who live here service those oil sands. And I'm right there with them. I'm right there on the front line. I'm right there on the ground with them. And I understand them, and I listen to them, and I see them every day, and I talk to them every day, like, constantly, right? So it's, I'm right there with them, and I share their concerns, and it's just the way it is, right?
There you go.
And your final question, what has been your favorite part of being able to campaign to locals in town?
Oh, my favorite part is just hearing all the different, the things that they want to see, right, in Fort McMurray.
Mm-hmm.
Creating efficiency, like, especially, is definitely one of them.
Yeah.
So through blockchain, we'd also be able to, through an app, through blockchain, maybe just the app, you know, it depends how it's well received, right?
Yeah.
We could streamline more decisions in the municipality. We can create more efficiency by having votes through the app, right? We could vote on names of parks, or we could vote on how the park is designed, right? Things like that.
Generalized people's things. Point of views.
Yeah, absolutely.
And those have been your five questions.
Well, I got to take a bit of the shine out there. I got to answer Tanner's question. I'm a salt and pepper wing guy with the hot sauce on the side. If you want some, you can dip it in. And yeah, I'm good with either bones or wings or the drumstick. But yeah, the wing more often than not is the way to go.
Yeah.
And bone in.
Bone in. Like,
yeah.
Don't get me wrong, boneless wings are cool.
They're glorified nuggets.
But I was just going to say that. They're glorified nuggets. I'm like, if I want a nugget, I'll get a nugget.
Oh, 100%. Yeah.
Because speaking of food now, I just got asked a question. Has anybody tried the new McNugget?
The spicy ones?
Oh, yeah. I have. Yeah.
You did?
bomb.
Yeah. You did too?
Yeah. I did. I tried them. Yeah, yeah.
How are they?
Yeah, they're okay. Like, I don't mind them.
You're expecting them to be spicier at the beginning.
Yeah.
But at the beginning, they just taste like a normal chicken.
Yes. Nugget. Yeah. The after.
And then you chew it and you swallow it, and then all of a sudden you get a whole heat.
Yeah. So what dipping sauce are you throwing down? I'm a sweet and sour guy.
I'm exactly the same. Sweet and sour. Yeah.
I don't dip.
Oh yeah, that's right.
I just eat the nugget.
That you just.
Although
eat nugget.
Yeah. My fiance is definitely into the ranch, and I've been having a lot more of that, so I'm definitely getting into the ranch.
Ranch? Yeah. Oh, don't tell Joey Diaz that.
Ranch is gross.
Yeah, on vegetables, it's fine. I don't know about nuggets, though.
Some, like, Midwesterners in the United States put that shit on everything.
Everything, yeah.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
I have no feeling for ranch. It's just there's this comedian Joey Diaz, Uncle Joey. I don't know if you know who he is. Oh, he has a skit about how he feels about ranch, and it's not rated for this show. It's hilarious. Yeah. So anytime somebody says ranch, I'm like, ugh. Yeah. Just because it's based on him. All right, so I know we're running short for time. That's the whole point of the show. 20 minutes long. Is there any, like, at the end of the show, everybody gets a shameless shout out or plug. Obviously you have something that you want to shout out and plug. So I'm going to throw the mic to you. The camera's on you. The mic's on you.
Oh,
let's hear your shameless shout out or plug.
Thank you. Well, my name's Tal Tupper, like I said, and I'd really like to try and create a more sense of community. And the best way to do that is from the inside, like I was saying. So when you go to vote on October 18th, give me a second thought.
There you go. Okay, so like, where can they find you? You got a Facebook page?
I have a website,
Website?
Let's... Yeah, www.voteforTupper.ca. That's four. That's the number four.
Number four?
Not F-O-R, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, voteforTupper.ca. You can also find me on Facebook.
Cool.
And Instagram.
Sweet. So have you been out there door knocking and stuff already? Or
I've just been going through the parks, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, waiting like around parks and handing out pamphlets.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Sweet. Well, dude, thank you very much for coming on the show. I tell everybody this. This is a platform that you can come back again and again and again. If you are successful for council, please come back.
Yeah.
If you're not, please come back and just come and hang out with myself and Tanner. It's a good time no matter what.
Yeah. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Yeah. No worries, my man. All right. Well, Fort McMurray, Wood Buffalo, and the rest of the world. That's been another episode of the Mac City Morning Show. Thank you very much for tuning in. It truly does mean the world to me. So thank you. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow. Peace.